Pick a side. You're on that side?
I'll be on this side.
Switch sides with me.
Oh.
That way, yeah, yeah. Because I'm shorter, so you'll see over me.
This is Ham Radio Now and
Phasing Line Podcast.
Ham Radio Now episode 321, I think.
Phasing Line Podcast, lots of episodes. No, yeah,
you don't number
we're
your
really
episodes.
Bad about this.
I'm too tall. I'm sticking. I'll go back in the booth here.
Yeah.
How's that? Does that work out better?
Here. Yeah. Let me see. Don't move.
Well,
you look good.
No, you need to be back here because
I know.
Just come back and do the show.
There's weird lighting.
Yeah. Yeah, kind of burning out. We got lights and stuff. So we've just got the stuff in the booth set up. We've already taken it back apart because it could rain and things could get
pretty
wet.
So we're basically in a tent.
Yeah.
And we're at the bottom of the pot.
We'll show you around in a minute.
Yeah.
We've got the most important thing. We got Arvin.
She holds the pig by the leg and get the roaming gnome.
Got the micro gnome. And we will set up with all the microphones and stuff. I took it apart because I don't want to leave it here. It could rain.
There's rain in the forecast.
First thing we do tomorrow is Tapper conference anyway.
Yep.
So all the cameras go over there. But now we're going to go show you around.
Let's see this place. It's new to me. It's new to him.
Yeah. It is Thursday.
4 in the afternoon.
3 o'clock.
3 o'clock.
3 o'clock.
Time flies.
Thursday, the setup day.
Yeah.
So we've already done a pre-dating show.
Yeah.
So this can't be the pre-Dayton show. I guess this is the setup
this
day
show. This is the
show.
Dayton, we're dating our way out of Dayton.
Yeah. Don't look at me. Look at the camera.
Yeah.
Haven't you ever watched TV?
Yeah. I don't produce it, though.
This is the setup day. So here's our setup day video and phasing line audio.
Phasing line audio, Ham Radio Now video. Let's go take a look. Let's go. What is this? Tent Central, I feel like. So,
well, yeah, we're going to do this kind of from backwards to the front in terms of the Ham Fest.
So this is kind of the intersection of the Tent City.
Yeah, and what we looked at when we were looking at the maps was it looked like it was one big tent.
Right.
And it's not. It's a bunch of little ones. Let me have you track this way. Stay in the camera. Start walking.
Yeah.
That was Tent 6, our tent.
So then there's what is that, 5?
Yeah. Well, it's all Building 6.
Right. And it wraps
and
all the way around.
This other
there's a
great big tent
here.
All still part of Building 6.
Behind me, there's another big tent. These are there's two big, like, big party wedding tents that are actually fairly close in size to the buildings. But there's two smaller tents. We're in one of the smaller tents. And the smaller tents are really quite small. There's only a few booths in them.
Yep, so some of our neighbors are worried about foot traffic. We don't particularly need
foot
traffic.
We don't want foot traffic.
In fact, we both forgot our banners, so no one's going to recognize who we are except for the little
phasing
mic flags.
Line now?
Yeah, no one's going to know who you are at all. And I've got a few little mic flags and signs.
I have plenty of name tags, but...
You do. You're well equipped for credentials.
Yeah.
You took some of them off. I told you to leave them all on.
Yeah, we'll get some of those more later.
Yeah.
But
so I've got two.
So now we're gonna keep moving. I think.
Yep, things are moving in.
People are just pouring in here. Actually, lots of empty booths still.
And there always were on Thursday.
Right.
Late Thursday is when people get in and set up, and then early Friday morning there'll be people here at 7 a.m. getting set up. So, show you a little bit more.
Let's go.
A lot more.
Are you recording?
We are recording. We're recording. Like a weatherman.
No, on the Gary and Marty
show. This isn't really here. This is a green screen.
Right, yeah. Last year we did this from the stands in the old place.
Yeah,
but,
so this is our 6,000 building.
We are here.
Yep.
We are literally, our booth is here.
And it does now look more like individual tents,
right.
You can tell.
So you can just see as far as magnitude. So there's 12 booths in this, and there's, you know, probably 50, just guesstimating in this one. So they're really
so two big tents, two little
small
tents.
But it's
this
three in a
back,
row.
This is the back 40. No one's coming back here.
Yeah.
Well, we'll see.
We'll see.
We'll find out.
We'll let you know.
Again, we don't care, but our neighbors, they're gonna.
They
care.
Might. There wasn't, to be honest, in our booth there was. There were some things I would expect to see in the back, but some now there's a jeweler, another jeweler, you know, the non-hammy things. But CQ Magazine was there.
I'll talk to you about non-hammy things sometime because they turn out important at a ham fest.
Yeah.
Because there's a lot of people that come, get dragged by spouses.
They need things to do.
By spice.
Yeah.
And they like seeing that stuff. I have a friend who does jewelry at ham fest, and she says some of her best shows are the ham fest shows.
Well, these men their wives are pissed off for going away for the day. You know, they need to bring back something nice.
Yep. All right, so moving on.
Let's keep going.
We're about to be run over by a gator here. All right, here's something for a little more perspective. Once again, this is the tent city. This is where we are and all the folks in the tents are. If you got in the RV queue early, then you are going to be able to park right here and be right next to the Hamfest with your RV. And so these are the guys that got in line at the very beginning for their RV. The rest of the Hamfest is just down the road. Marty, you want to pan on down the road and finish off that perspective, and we'll show you what's going on. And this poor fellow has been trying to stay out of our camera range, and we keep panning over to get in the way. So now we got to find out who he is. Back over here, who are you?
Who are you?
John, KB2ERJ.
Where are you from?
Syracuse, New York.
So you came a little ways. You drive?
Flew.
All right, and boy, is his arms tired. Boom, boom.
Yeah, they are.
Okay, come on in, Marty. You can be part of this.
Photos of Marty because he's, active with the W5KUB group. So, and I'm with.
Are you in W5KUB also?
Occasionally, I'm a trader.
Well, I noticed he had a badge over there for you, so.
Yeah. Apparently.
So I'm helping him. I'm taking photos and.
Great.
Putting him out on the chat room so people...
Oh, so that's why he's nervous, because he's stuck on ham radio now, and he knows that Tom is going to be mad at
him.
The gig is up now, so, yeah.
Now, Tom and I are fast friends.
Yes.
Yeah, I've known Tom for a number of years now.
So Tom does webcasts. He's streaming it live, basically, to anybody.
Right.
So.
Exactly. He brings ham radio to the world.
So if you're watching this now, you missed your opportunity.
Yes.
Because Tom... Stop streaming.
I'm going to try to get this on tonight.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
That's why
I'm not coming to play with you tonight.
Yeah.
Okay, on to the rest of the Hamfest. Say hi to Tom for me.
I'm sorry?
Say hi to Tom for me.
Oh, absolutely, I will.
We'll get over there.
Yep. Please do.
Yep.
It's a little hectic today, but, with all the setup, but...
And now get away from my camera.
Somehow.
Yeah, go.
All right.
Let's go.
Get lost.
So it's important to note here at Ham Radio Now and the Facing Line, I guess, we use some very, very technical means of doing the videography. Gary is employing the table system, which is something we use here a lot. But anyways, we are in the kind of the central square here, and this is kind of the intersection of everything. So over here, we have the forums rooms, and there's three, I believe, maybe a little bit more. And these are actually supposed to be gigantic and beautiful. We haven't been able to get into them right now, but we will later this weekend. And tomorrow morning, actually, we'll be shooting the Tapper Forum here, or at least Gary will. And so we have three forums rooms, and they're quite big, and they're actually kind of the nicest spaces here at Hamvention. The rest of them are just shell buildings. And as we continue on kind of in the circle, and we have what I'm warmly calling Food Alley. And, it would not be a ham event without a lot of food, and we certainly have it here. So there's... food trucks upon food trucks upon food trucks. So we probably have, 15 different food vendors down here. And then as we continue on with the tour, we have even more food vendors over here. And that's another forum room. Excuse me, there's two here, I believe, and one there. And from there, we can kind of continue on in this circle. And we have building number 5 way down there. And that's where booths like Heil Sound and W5KUB and some other vendors are all the way down there. And then kind of take the loop. Let's see if we can cross over here. We start with Marconi Hall. You'll note the very technical hall names. All the way on that end. I believe that's building 3. And then we have building 2, which is called Tesla Hall. As we walk around, that's kind of the middle building. That's also the biggest building. It's where all the offices is, where the restrooms are. Hopefully those restrooms will stay clean throughout Hamvention. And then all the way at the end, we have Maxim Hall, which will be coming up into view here in a second. And Maxim Hall and I believe it's, let's see. Marconi Hall, excuse me. Maxim Hall and Marconi Hall are the same size. While Tesla is the biggest one here. So we're going to continue on. We'll take a look at building 5, which is a smaller building, all the vendors. And so let's keep going now. We're going to start here at building 1. So let's go take a look. Follow me. Let's go.
This is the Maxim building. Building one, maybe, but Maxim is what they call it here. So this is where the big guys are. Step IR, MFJ, Meritron, R&L Electronics is here. It's got metal sides, a real roof, some air handling, not air conditioning, but at least the air is moving. It's not bad today. It's probably in the 80s. I don't think it's going to get a whole lot hotter. So not as sweltering as I thought it could be, but we'll see back in the tents. It could be pretty bad. If it rains, and it will rain, these guys are pretty well protected. We don't know what we're going to get back in Tent City. So I imagine that the other buildings are going to look about the same. Oh, I see a giant setup down there that doesn't look like it's very far along. It's looking a little Kenwood-ish. So let's go see if that's Kenwood.
You ready for a good show?
Oh, yeah.
It's going to be a great show, isn't it?
Ready for a great show, Marty.
So what do you think of the new place?
I love the new place. I think it's more homey. It's more human.
Yeah.
It's more windy, but I like it.
We need some air conditioning.
It's homey, and I like the food outside. It's really great.
Yeah, that's great. All right. We'll see ya.
Eat some ice cream.
Eat some ice cream.
Who was that best man?
What?
Who was that best
man? That is Richard from MFJ. He is Mr. Customer Service, Mr. Sales. Good guy.
Where are you?
Yeah, okay. So we are here at the Kenwood booth, and Kenwood has always kind of had a small, grungy, old-looking booth. I've never really been impressed. But take a look. I feel like we're in an Apple store now. All these flat-screen TVs and glass. I mean, glass, it looks quite impressive. I don't see any spots where they would perhaps have a new HF radio, so that's kind of disappointing. They're still showing their TS-2000 and what looks like a TS-480, even though the TS-2000 is almost a 17-year-old radio. You'd think they'd be a little bit more inventive. But it looks like Kenwood generally has a big, nice display. The big booths are definitely bigger here. I know ICOM is a bigger booth, and we'll take a look at that in a minute. MFJ, R&L. This is kind of a big hall for vendors. So another part of the building we see here is the Viroplex booth. And Viroplex actually is a bunch of brands that they distribute for. So there's Spiderbeam and Inrad and Viroplex, and there's the Spiderbeam poles, and we see 403A antenna switching and just a lot of stuff. Next to them, though, is the Elecraft booth. Elecraft is well known for their famous K3 radio and the rest of this stuff. They are catering. But one of the things that they also do is HF amplifiers and small portable radios. This year, they actually just released a 1,500-watt linear amplifier. And I'm not sure if we'll see that at the show. I certainly don't see it out here. But Elecraft is here with lots and lots of cool radios. And typically, you will see this booth flooded on Friday morning.
So Michael Coulter has told us that the bathrooms are going to be great. He almost sounded like Donald Trump about it. Uh-oh, we're being photobombed. Who could that possibly be? It's Ham Radio 2.0. All right, so I'm going to take a camera in the restroom and find out. Here we go. Is there anybody in here? There was nobody in here a moment ago. We got showers,
which these hams could really use.
So Hera didn't have showers. There's the usual line of stalls, and nobody here. Right? Okay. Whoa. That is not good. Ladies. You don't know what these are, right? Okay, and it generally looks pretty clean, except for that one toilet that somebody either didn't or couldn't flush. Oh, look, it's your intrepid camera operator. And so before it gets too busy in here, we'll get out. I like the acoustics, though. La, 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 la. Who are you?
I'm Patty.
So you knew the answer to the first question right away.
Yeah,
you're in charge of lemonade. You're the lemonade queen.
Well, lemonade shake-ups. We've got kettle corn and iced tea.
What did they tell you you were coming to bring your lemonade stand to?
Hamvention.
And what does that mean to you?
I don't know.
It means nothing to you?
No, this is our first time.
Well, it's the first time it's been here. It moved over from Hera. You know Hera Arena, right?
Yes, I do.
Long lamented Hera Arena?
Yes. Yeah.
Did you ever go there, work there, do anything there?
No, I have not.
Never even been there?
No, I don't think so.
But did it make a lot of news here that Hera Arena was getting torn down?
Yes, I've heard that. Yes.
Okay. So somebody said there's something going on here at Greene County Fairgrounds. Bring your lemonade stand.
That's right. My husband and I have done the fair here at Greene County before with our concessions.
All right. Did they tell you how many people to expect?
Well, we've heard anywhere from 20 to 60,000.
Okay, I'd kind of lean toward the lower end of that, but we all hope for the higher end. The event has typically been 20 to 25,000, and they're hoping for more. We'll see what happens. In any case, you got enough lemonade.
Well, we hope so, yes. We're close to a grocery store that we could make a trip if we need to.
And it is the world's most delicious lemonade?
Of course.
It doesn't look like you squeeze these by hand.
No.
You use a squeezer.
Yeah.
All right. And you make these guys do all the squeezing, right?
Yes.
All right, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
There's Marty manning the camera. I can't hear him,
but
he can
hear
me.
Yeah.
So back behind me now is the village square where all of the big buildings are circled around and the forums and stuff like that. And if we head this way, we'll get... and it's a lot of walking, we're going to get back to where the flea market gets started. So, can't really see very much of it because of vehicles and stuff, but we'll walk back in there, and that's the flea market territory. So let's check out the fleas.
Let's go. I'm rolling, but we are rolling.
Go 3, 2, 1, bip.
3, 2, 1, bip.
There you go.
There's a loud
spike. Okay, you're on.
Let me. So here we are. We are kind of on the back end of what was the what is a racetrack for horses. You can actually see some horse prints down here. But this is the flea market. So the flea market's actually in the inner circle of the track, and in the flea market here, we see lots of people who are just setting up their tents, getting ready to sell things. And tomorrow, when we get here, the flea market will be just full of people, full of people. And there's lots of things to see and lots of things to buy. And you got some porta potties, so people won't have to work out. So it's going to be, looks like the flea market's going to be a lot of fun. It certainly looks smaller, but we're going to have a lot of fun.
Marty is complaining that the camera's a little bit cattywampus. That is a hallmark of ham radio now. Don't tell anyone, but we both climbed over this fence. And... this is the fastest way from the flea market over there into the Hamfest over here, but it's, you know, pretty much all wired shut. I'm assuming that it's going to be open during the actual Hamfest because you don't want people to have to walk long ways around to get from the flea market to the Hamfest. Over here, this is the track, and I had misunderstood. I thought that Michael Coulter had said that the flea market would be set up on the track as well as in the infield. Well, clearly it's not. And there's still some empty green space out there in case they need to expand the flea market. But, I also understand that he was saying that there'll be horses on here at night, so they'll have to kind of clear out. I don't know if they have to clear out everything in there. I'm assuming not. No, they couldn't have to do that. But all the people have to leave. So let's go in and look at some happy fleas. I'll come around to you guys. I think this looks like a typical ham radio flea market confab. Who are you?
Andy Bow.
Call sign?
WB8HYO, Youngstown, Ohio.
I'll get over to you in a second. It takes a moment to move around. So you're out here in the new Dayton Xenia flea market.
We're hoping this is going to be it. New adventure for everybody. Hopefully it'll be a lot of fun, nice weather. Good time coming out here to see where Dayton had gone all the years, and we were wondering where it was going now. Maybe it's a new hope here, and we're going to expand some more.
Do you see, clearly, I mean, everything is different, but what do you see as advantages, disadvantages?
I think some of the advantages that we see now are that we're down here with motorhomes, where that was not really accommodated down before at the other venue. We have on-site camping.
That's your big school bus here?
No, it's a friend of mine's, but I have a motorhome. We're back in a camping lot. We're back there, going to have some camping out and some flea market, but my 49 years for me, I think, right now. So
you're a newcomer.
I'm a new guy, yeah. Get a 50-year pin next year, hopefully. Huh?
Some big difference for you in the flea market here is you're on grass instead of cement.
Yeah, I just hope that they tell us it's good drainage. Well, that'll wait to be seen when the weather, if it stays nice, hopefully we'll be good. But if it rains real bad, this could become a tow truck paradise here.
Well, it has rained pretty hard off and on the past couple of days, and it doesn't seem wet down here. I don't see mud.
No, it looks pretty good. I'm surprised. We came in a big four-wheeler, and I don't even see the tracks in the grass. It's drained quite well.
And it's not likely to erupt in sewage.
No. That was a wonderful year there. Fortunately, it wasn't in one of our spots, but that was about as worse as it gets. That was pretty bad.
Okay, so you're cautiously optimistic.
Yes, and I tell you what, I got to give thanks to all the great guys that I met, Dave Trish, Jack Gerbs. Those guys did a wonderful job helping me get some things organized, but just in general, putting this thing on and moving it to this new venue. You know, all these guys are giving their time to do it. It's all free, and they're doing it for the ham community, so I'm hoping it's going to be a great venue for them, and it turns out to be a great success.
Did you think twice about whether you wanted to come, or did you know you're going to come no matter what?
Oh, I was coming no matter what. This is Dayton. You know, you got to come here. I got to see what's going on. I wanted to see the changes, and I wanted to get involved and say I was there for the first one at the new place.
All right. Well, have fun. What do you sell here?
We got a little bit of everything. We have from ham radio to two-way communications to test equipment. We got a wide variety of things here, so. It's just a fun outing of things guys collect all the, from our hobbies and everything else and some old businesses we had throughout the years. But right now it's just a setup day, and you're getting a lot of action here today. Most of them are people that are vendors in the flea market. Tomorrow will be probably a good crowd from what they're telling me. I'm hoping we hit the 35,000 they said are supposed to be here. So
I hope so too. People tell me that if you want to get the best deal at a flea market, you got to be a vendor and get around before the show opens.
To some extent, that's true. Those are some of the good deals, but some good deals also happen late Saturday and early Sunday. So if things don't go, you don't get the price you're asking, some people get some pretty good deals on those days. You hang around till late Saturday afternoon or early Sunday morning.
So no one key thing to do, you got to be there.
No, and most of the people here today are vendors. Look, you know, they're buying things here and there and sharing. You're sharing stories, you're meeting friends. You know, I come here, we have friends flying in from all over the country. I see them once a year, and it's here. And it's a wonderful thing, you know, to come here. And
you ever sell a radio cheap on Thursday and then see it marked up on somebody's table on Saturday?
I've been here, 49 years? 490 times.
So that happened.
We used to do it. We used to buy ham rigs, take them back to the hotel, clean them all up, spit shine them. Add 100 and put it back on the table, and it'd sell. You know, somebody wanted it. You found the right buyer for it.
You're learning all the secrets here on Ham Radio Now. Okay, I got to go talk to your friend.
Okay.
Thank you.
So who are you?
I'm Jerry Katzenmeyer, N8BHU.
Where are you from?
Kent, Ohio.
So you didn't have a very long trip at all.
No. I came down with the fellow that drives the bus here, and I drove the van that gets us back and forth to the hotel. And this had all of our wares to sell in it.
That looks like a pretty sweet deal.
Well, I think it is. No, it's very interesting coming down here. I've been doing it, I don't know how many years now, but there's people that you see here that you only, like Andy said here, you only see them once a year. You may talk to them on the radio through the year, but you see them down here in person. And even after the Ham Fest, you may go out to eat with some of them and socialize. So it's really a lot of fun.
Once you got here, was it what you expected to see after all the publicity?
I had no idea what to expect. I mean, it's a different, it's a whole different situation here. I hope for the best here. We'll see what happens over the rest of the weekend.
What's your comparison with Harris so far?
Oh, I think it'll be all right. I like I like some of the food vendors we've got out here. And it's nice to have the camping close here for some of the people that travel down here in campers, so they can park here on the property. So that works out really well.
It might even be a little cooler on the grass.
Well, yeah, that asphalt can get pretty hot. You never know what you're going to get in Dayton. You may get snow, you may get rain, you may get, you know, boil on the pavement. You just don't know what you're going to get.
All right, you guys have a fun weekend.
Okay, you too. Thank you.
I got to get a ham radio story back here. Ham radio? Why would there be a ham radio story?
This is a wonderful story. I had a friend, he flies from Australia, that used to stay with me, and he'd come down to this ham fest. And one day, him and I are walking around the ham fest, and he has his call letters on his hat. And these four German hams come up to him, who had flown over, obviously, from Germany.
Let me interrupt your story, because I'm noticing you're F1RE. You're a French ham.
Yeah, French ham. That's right. These four Germans read his hat, and they walk up to him, and they're standing there talking to him. They're looking at him, and they're talking among themselves. And he speaks German, and he looks at me and says, "They're talking about me." And I go, "Really?" He goes, "Yeah, I talked to them over 20 years on the low band, but we've never met eye to eye until right now." He said, "They recognized my call." He said, "I never thought that I'd ever run into these guys anywhere, and here they are in Dayton, Ohio."
That is ham radio, and that is Dayton.
That's ham radio, and that's Dayton. So God bless them. I hope this turns out for the best for everybody.
Okay, you guys have fun. Oh, darn. I was going to get a shot of Marty, who was looking away from the camera. His attention was, totally focused somewhere else, paying no attention to what's going on here. So I have no idea what the video is going to look like, but Marty was off the ball.
What's your name and call sign?
My name is Philip. Call sign is Kilo Charlie 9 India Oscar Oscar.
And you're selling what? Looks like a bunch of Motorola radios.
I'm selling a lot of Motorola equipment, a little bit of Harris equipment, a lot of surplus public safety equipment.
So is this all? This has all been taken out of service and it's now for sale?
For the most part, yes. Some of it is new demo equipment. Mm-hmm. A lot of it's reconditioned. A lot of it is just surplused by public safety, and it's being made available here at the Hamfest.
Is this your first time here? Have you been here a bunch? Or?
I've been here for about 20 years in a row.
So how do you, so what do you think? We're in a new venue, yay, nay? How's it going to go?
It's not open yet, so it's hard to tell. Right now there's a lot of vendors here, but it's a smaller area. Everything's more compacted, so it's just very hard to judge how it's going to turn out at this point. So far, so good. We're doing all right.
What do you think about the flea market itself?
Again, it's hard to tell. Best asked and best answered question probably tomorrow night or Saturday morning sometime.
So have you happy you came back this year? Was it worth the trip?
All I can say to that is it's not Dayton if it's not raining, and we got clobbered coming in this morning.
So it was Dayton.
There you go. It's Dayton.
So they've been talking about that it's possible that they'll see possibly even 35,000 people, but they haven't seen that in a very, very long time. Is that going to happen?
I will optimistically hope that it does. If it does, it's going to be a great year.
Well, I'm looking forward to seeing it. Hopefully it does. But you have a whole gang here. What's your name?
Andrew.
You have a call sign?
No.
You're just down here for the ride?
Yeah.
You've been here before?
Yeah.
So what do you think of this place compared to the old one?
It's boring.
Why is it so boring? Is the food better?
No.
This is just a mess?
It's crowded.
Yeah. Okay. What's your name?
Emily.
Are you a ham?
No.
Why not?
Never really been interested in that.
Just here. And how does this, look, there's a gorgeous grass field. It's not raining.
It's muddy.
Where's their mud? I don't see any mud.
If it rains and it always rains, there's gonna be mud.
So it could be muddy.
It could be muddy.
Okay. We'll see. Maybe it will. Maybe it won't.
Okay, come on over here.
Well, hey, I knew what to do. I now know what not to do. So we did the tour.
You're learning. So this appears to be a little room left. These spaces may fill in by tomorrow morning or Saturday. Some folks can't get here on Friday. Not everybody is either unemployed student or an unemployed retired
old man.
But it looks like it's filling up. The last fellow said that it's smaller, so
I think we see a lot of cautious optimism.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Everybody wants it to be a great ham fest.
Some people don't, but I think most people.
Yeah, I discount the folks who don't want it.
Yeah.
There are plenty of people who are not sure.
Right.
I'll count myself in the skeptics that it would not necessarily be great, because every ham fest that I've known that moved took a big hit.
Right.
But this is Dayton.
This is Dayton.
This is a Trump year. Last year it was absolutely unexpected, and the unexpected happened. He was unique. Dayton is unique. It could
maybe this will be the biggest hamvention ever. We'll have to see.
So you weren't happy with that last interview?
Yeah.
You're learning.
I'm learning.
Give yourself a break. You're learning the craft.
I'm learning. What did you think of this? Tell us in the comments. You know what? I'll read them.
What? It sucked. That's not very nice.
Tell me what you think. You want to hear.
All right. Show of hands. Who would rather see Marty on Ham Radio now?
Who would rather see
me on Ham Radio?
His show.
We're going to wrap this thing up. You got to go.
Yeah. All right. It's been real.
I'm going to try to get this edited tonight. I'll be up all night long in the hotel room.
You're a professional.
Yeah.
We'll see. Bye-bye.
Oh, wait.
But wait.
Arvin.
There's more. Arvin wants
back
your
in the
money.
Booth. Is back in the booth. HamRadioNow.tv.
PhasingLinePodcast.com.
Over.
And out. Get out of my...
Anticipating that this program will be rough.
Why? Because I'm an idiot?
What? Am I rolling?
No.
Well, roll.